Sometimes dreams come true in real life, just like in the movies. In a search for fresh young faces to spark a new comedy film, Where Angels Go, Trouble Follows, Columbia Pictures launches a unique personality contest spanning 8 states. And for 8 star-struck Cinderellas, the dream of being in a movie becomes a reality. The winners come in all shapes and sizes, as petite as a pixie is Pert Vivian Gradine of Plano, Texas. Mary Jo Begley from Dayton, Ohio, is a softball enthusiast who aspires to stage and screen. Chicago-born Sue Ellen Helen has done professional modeling since the tender age of 4. Janice Eaton is the athletic type. She played guard in her high school basketball team in Kingfisher, Oklahoma. Betsy Jindal is a Philadelphian. Her pet peeve is her naturally curly hair. Barbara Bowman wants to be a nurse. She's from St. Louis, Missouri. Indiana's winner, Cindy Lou Rumpel, plans to study law. And Patricia Eves, New Mexico State Fair queen, is a rodeo equestrian who has won nearly 700 trophies and blue ribbons. In their cross-country safari for location filming of Where Angels Go, Trouble Follows, their biggest thrill is the opportunity to meet and work with glamorous stars like Rosalind Russell, even if she does spoil their fun in the line of duty.
As of now, St. Francis Argogo is out of business.
The girls find Stella Stevens, alias Sister George, fun to travel around with. And up and down with, too. They're on their best behavior for Arthur Godfrey, because he's the bishop. But Van Johnson is extremely popular, because he's where the boys are. They get a chance to shake a leg or two during a lively dance-in held in the gymnasium of the boys' school. As one girl commented, just imagine doing this and getting paid for it, too. There's never a dull moment as they wend their way in the St. Francis Academy bus, the most temperamental star in the picture. Caravan arrives at Rancho Alegre, a 1,600-acre spread near Santa Fe, New Mexico. It's another first for most of the girls who've never been on a real working ranch before, and a special thrill for Patricia Eves, because this is her home, and she's proud to play hostess to her fellow contest winners and her new Hollywood friends. There are no formalities here, as stars and extras mingle with technicians and ranch hands on a first-come, first-served basis. In these off-camera periods, the girls get better acquainted with veteran performers like Benny Barnes, Robert Taylor, and Mary Wicks. And with the ingenue leads, Susan St. James and Barbara Hunter. But now it's time to get down to business again. The business of making a movie. Cameras and lights are being jockeyed into position. Director James Nielsen lines up the next shot. The producer, William Fry, meets with the ranch owner to discuss livestock. Ordinarily, you wouldn't think of a cattle stampede as something you'd have to rehearse. But if the animals miss their cue and go that-a-way instead of this-a-way, the cameraman will complain bitterly to the director. After they've rounded up the strays, the wranglers stage a rodeo in the old corral. Cheered on by our exuberant contest winners, who've been nicknamed the Angel Brigade. Our Angel Brigade hits the road once more. In the middle of the desert, they run into a traffic jam. When they finally get untangled from the Indians, they still have Milton Berle to contend with.
If I wanted a bust in my picture, I would have put a bust in my picture. But this is 1855, and the pioneers were very backward.
Next stop, Hollywood, where continuing excitement and surprise adventures are guaranteed.
You know where angels go. Trouble follows.